God bless you. I want to welcome everyone who is together with us here and those who are following us online. Feel at the feet of Jesus. We'll go straight to the Word of God, the book of Genesis, chapter 15. Genesis chapter 15. I want to talk about God will do it. God will do it. Genesis chapter 15, from verse 1 to verse 7. The Bible says, after these things, the word of the Lord came to Abraham in a vision, saying, "Do not be afraid, Abraham. I am your shield and your exceedingly great reward." But Abraham said, "Lord God, what will you give me, seeing I go childless, and the heir of my house is Eliezer of Damascus?" Then Abraham said, "Look, you have given me no offspring. Indeed, one born in my house is my heir." And behold, the word of the Lord came to him, saying, "This one shall not be your heir, but one who will come from your own body shall be your heir." Then he brought him outside and said, "Look now toward heaven and count the stars, if you are able to number them." And he said to him, "So shall your descendants be." And he believed the Lord, and he accounted it to him for righteousness. Then he said to him, "I am the Lord who brought you out of Ur of the Chaldeans to give you this land to inherit it." Hallelujah. This is a story of Father Abraham, and they are having a conversation with God, the Almighty God, the creator of the heavens and the earth. And he's the one who starts this conversation. So, for the Bible says that after these things, the word of the Lord came to Abraham in a vision, saying, "Do not be afraid. I am your great, exceedingly, I am your exceedingly great reward." Now, this is Father Abraham. And we see God starts speaking to him and telling him, "Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid." It is God who is telling Abraham. And we know very well, Abraham, he is the father of faith. But God is coming, encouraging him, trying to uplift him. Because according to what God is telling him, Abraham is afraid, for God is not a liar. God is not a liar. He can see what we cannot see. So it is God who comes to Abraham, telling him, "Abraham, do not be afraid." That tells you, he was suffering at that time with fear. There are some things that he was afraid of. There are some things that were bringing him down. Even if he had not shared with anyone, God himself, being a friend of Abraham, he knew very well what Abraham was going through. Hallelujah. And we see him encouraging him, trying to uplift him, that, "Abraham, I know very well what you're going through." And God is telling him, "Do not be afraid. I am your shield and your great exceedingly reward. I am there for you." Saints of God, I'm here to tell you that God knows you. He knows what you're going through. And if the father of faith is suffering with fear, hello, what about the children of faith? Because we see him as our role model. He's the father of faith. That tells me, even us who are the children, there are some things that we are going through and we are suffering with fear. Maybe you have not shared with anyone, just like your father Abraham. The Almighty God, the creator of the heaven and the earth, he knows you very well. Amen. He knows what you are going through. Amen. And he knows your fears. Uh-huh. He knows your fears. And he's telling you, "Do not be afraid. For we have not been given the spirit of fear, but the spirit of power, the spirit of sound mind, and the spirit of love. Father Abraham, he's suffering with fear. Nobody knows, but God Almighty, his friend, he knows. And he's telling, I'm your shield, I'm your protection. I'll be there for you. Not only that, I'll be your reward. I'll be your reward. And you know what? In the book of Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6, there is that God is a rewarder of those who seek him diligently. He is not a robber. You who have been seeking God, you whose your heart is after God, that you love God, that you are going after God, your mind, your thoughts, your talk, your walk is after God. Your eyes are on him who is the author and the finisher of your faith. Do you know what? He's a rewarder. You just continue. This was Abraham. And by this time, Abraham is 86 years old. According to the next chapter, chapter 16, the last verse, it talks of when they were giving birth to Ishmael, he was 86 years old. By this time, he's 86 years old, but he's afraid. He's suffering with fear. And we can see what he was afraid of. Because verse 2, it talks of God gives Abraham an opportunity of Abraham talking to him and explaining to him and pouring out his heart and his fears to God. Because we see now Abraham telling God that, God, you know very well, I'm going childless. I don't have a child. He's speaking to God and pouring out his heart, telling God, I'm suffering. It is true you have blessed me. I have servants, I have cattle, I have gold, I have silver, but I still have my shortcomings. There is something I'm trusting and believing you for. He's telling God about his fears, pouring out his heart to God. And sense of God, we must learn how to avail ourselves. In the book of Philippians, chapter 4, verse 6, the Bible talks of making your request known to God. Don't assume that he knows. Don't assume. Abraham was assuming that God knows what I need. God knows my fears. God knows what I'm going through. Until God came to him, talking to him and telling him about his fears, that's the time that he started pouring out his heart, telling God what he's fearing and what he's going through. Don't wait until that time. The Bible says that pouring our heart to God, making our request known to him, known to him. Sense of God, the heavens are open. We have been given access. The curtains, after Jesus saying it is finished, they were cut into two. We can have that access to the throne room of God. We don't need a high priest to go and pray for us. For even we have a high priest, who is Jesus Christ. You can join him at the right hand of God. He lives to make intercession for us, to pray for us. But even as for you, we say that, seek and you shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened. I'm here to tell you, if you have been praying, continue praying. If you have been seeking, continue seeking. Continue seeking. In the book of Isaiah 55 verse 6, the Bible says that, seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him when he is near. Seek him, call upon him when he is near. And you know what? His ears are open to your cry. His ears are open to your fear. It is true, you have some fears, but you have somewhere that you can run to. Abraham, he's talking about Eliezer of Damascus. He's telling God, God, it is only this servant that you have given me. He is the one who shall inherit my inheritance and possess everything that you have given me. Look at the thoughts of Abraham. That is his thinking. That is what he's trying to program according to him. But you know what? The ways of God are not our ways. His thoughts are not our thoughts. We see God rebuking Abraham, telling Abraham, Abraham, those are your thoughts. Those are your plans. As for me, that is not my plan. That is not my program. That is not what I want to do. Do you know what? No eye has seen. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9. No eye has seen, no ear has heard, neither has it entered into the heart of anyone, the things that the Lord has prepared for those who love him. There are some things that the Lord has prepared for you. You who is listening to me, you who is hearing this message, God has good thoughts and good plans. God has some blessings for you. But don't try to box God according to your thoughts, according to your plans. You must surrender to him. And you must enter into his plans for you to see that which he has for you coming to pass. Hallelujah. Amen. God talks of some trust in chariots, others in horses. But we shall remember the name of the Lord. We shall remember the name of the Lord. We shall remember the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Don't lean on your own understanding. Like Abraham. Proverbs 3, verse 5. Abraham is trying to lean on his own program, on his own thoughts, on what he wants and what he thinks. But that is not the will of God. That is not the plan of God. We must learn how to surrender to what God has and what God wants with us. Hallelujah. So God dismisses the plans of Abraham by telling him, that is your plan about Eliezer of Damascus, about what you're trying to tell me. That this is what you think, and this is the plan that you have to give him everything that I have given him. That is your plan. Sense of God. The Bible talks of the name of the Lord is a strong tower. And not only that, Psalms 124, verse 8, that our help is in the name of the Lord. Our help is in the name of the Lord. So I'm trying to encourage you that you must continue calling upon him. You must continue seeking him and surrendering to him, for he has good thoughts for you. I'm being reminded, look at this guy in the book of Bethsaida, in the book of John, chapter 5, verse 6. John chapter 5, it is starts from verse 1 going down. The Bible talks of a certain guy in the pool of Bethsaida that Jesus came and knowing very well that this guy had been there for 38 years, he said to him, do you want to be made well? Hear what he said. That, sir, I don't have any man. When the waters are stirred, to throw me there. You see, he's trying to go with the programs and the plans and everything that has been happening. Those are his thoughts. It is true, an angel used to come down and stir the water. And anyone who used to get there first in that pool, he used to get well. He used to be healed. But now this is the master. Jesus himself, the healer, who has been doing it on that pool. He's there asking this guy that, do you want to be made well? And you know what? He's talking about, I don't have anyone. I don't have any man. Those are his thoughts. And that is what we have been doing. That, you know what? I don't have any connection. I don't have what it takes. I don't have the papers. I don't know anyone in that office. I don't have any relative. I don't have the capital to start that business. I don't know who can help me, who can assist me. That is what we have been saying. Forgetting that there is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. This person is talking of, I don't have anyone. I don't have any man. When Messiah, the Lord himself, is there. Sense of God, what have you been believing God for? As Abraham, don't try to go with your own thoughts. As this guy in the pool of Bethsaida, don't try to program God that when God wants to bless me, he can only use this route. He can only use this sister or this brother. He can only use this door. Don't try to program God. God is God, and he can use any route and any path to come lifting you up I know God uses men. God can connect you with burden bearers and destiny helpers. Hello. But God is God. God is God. He said one time to disciples that if you don't praise me, the stones can do it. God is God. God is God. He used a donkey to speak. God is God. Don't try to box God on your own thoughts and your own plans. You must be flexible. Don't be like the children of Israel. Stiff-necked people. Walikuwa na shingo ngumu. You must be flexible. Allowing God to guide you and to lead you.
Amen.
Allow Him to order your steps.
Hello.
The steps of a good man, they are ordered by God. Allow Him to come through for you in a way that He wants to come through for you.
Hello.
But don't try to box Him, for He is God. Now, we see the story of Abraham. The Bible talks of God. God brought Abraham out of that tent. Why? He was limited by the tent.
Hello.
And some of us, we are limited by where we are. By the people that have surrounded us. By the things that we see. By the things that we hear. They have limited us. You must come out of those people, out of that company that is not trying to uplift you and to take you to the next level. There are some friends that you must say bye-bye to.
Hello.
There are some programs and some books that you must put aside. They are limiting you. They are limiting you. God brought Abraham out of the tent. And God said to him, now lift up your eyes to the heavens. And I want you to count the stars. Number them. And if you can do it, so shall be your descendants. Hear what God is saying. God is telling Abraham to do something that only God can do. Only God can count the stars. Not only that, He knows them by numbers. If you can look at the book of Psalms 147, verse 4, you see that He counts the stars by numbers and He calls them by name. Psalms 147, verse 4. God only can do that, calling each every star by name and counting them. That is only God who can do. What is God telling Abraham?
Mm-hmm.
That Abraham, I can do exceedingly, abundantly, more than you can think or ask or even imagine. This is Abraham. He doesn't have even one child. But God is talking about descendants. God is trying to bring him to visions. Do you know what? May your eyes be enlightened. May your eyes be enlightened. That you can see that which God has for you. Because if you can see it, you can have it. It is about you. Don't limit yourself. You must continue believing God, trusting God, and allow God even to stretch you. Because you see God stretching Abraham. He's telling him, now count the stars. Number them one by one. So that you may know, so that you may not go. If you count number one, you will have to go to number two. That's why he's being told, number them one by one. God is God. God is God. In verse 15, we see God telling Abraham, because Abraham believed God. Abraham believed God after being told to count the stars. This is God telling Abraham to count the stars. The God who calls those things which are not as though they are.
Hello.
And the God who brings the dead to life. Romans 4, verse 17. Now we see God telling Abraham that in verse 6, and he believed God. Abraham believed God. Do you know what? The only thing that you need to do is just to believe God. Only to believe God. God wants you to believe Him. Only that. And after that, the book talks of, and Abraham was accounted righteous only because of that. He became righteous. Right, righteousness means right standing with God. He came to the level of agreeing with God. That God, I believe you. You'll give me a child. That God, I believe you. You'll bless me. That God, I believe you. You'll promote me. That God, I believe you. You'll deliver me out of these curses. These generational things that have been happening in my family. Lord, I believe you. I'm out of it. For I'm a new creation. The old has gone, behold, the new has come. God, I believe you that you're giving me a new song. God, I believe you that you have removed sackcloth from me, clothes of shame, and you have clothed me with a garment of praise. God, I believe you. He believed God. And you know what? The only thing that you need to do, just believe God. Just believe. What is God saying concerning him? What is God saying concerning this year? Just listen to the voice of God and believe him. You may not know how it will happen, but believe him. Don't try to find out of how will it happen. Abraham could have done that. He could have asked God, God, you're talking about the stars. How will this happen? But he did it. Don't talk so. He believed God. He believed God. The only thing that you need to do is just to believe God. And you know what? The children of Israel, the Bible talks in the book of Hebrews chapter 3, verse 19, that they did not enter into their rest because of unbelief. These people, they did not enter Canaan. They did not inherit the inheritance. They did not possess their possessions. God had delivered them out of Egypt. God had walked with them in the wilderness. God was providing for them. He was always there for them. But you know what? They did not enter into their rest because of unbelief. Sense of God, that will make you not possess your possession. That will make you not inherit your inheritance. The only thing, as simple as it is, only believing. Look at the book of Mark chapter 6, verse 6 as I conclude. The Bible talks of Jesus of Nazareth, that when he came to his hometown, he could not have done many signs and wonders. He only healed few sick people. Why? Because of their unbelief. They did not believe. Nazareth, that city that Jesus had grew up. They were saying like this, is not this the carpenter? Is not this the son of Mary? The brother of James, Joseph, and Judas? Are not his sisters here with us? Unbelief was birthed into their hearts. And that stopped the Christ. That hindered, that tied the hands of Jesus, that he could not have done many things that he wanted to do. Sense of God, the only thing you need to do is just believe. Amen. Only believe. All things are possible to him who believes. Only believe. That is only the only thing that we need to do today. Abraham believed God. Abraham believed God. Lord.